Do you see this path? This was made by humans. This is how they used to travel in this time. They just walked everywhere they needed to go. But after a point, they figured out that they could interact with and use the animals around them. They used to tame horses, sit on their backs, and direct the animals wherever they wanted to go. Soon, they started building saddles with animal skin so that they could seat themselves better on the horse, you know, be a little more comfortable. To travel, we now used animal legs, not ours. By this time, they had also figured out how to travel over water by making primitive boats made out of logs of wood with holes in them. Over time, the build of the boats became better, more complicated. They figured out how to join two pieces of wood together. They started building the boats based on the shape of fishes so that they could wade through the waters better. But the most significant and important invention that happened in this time is the wheel. So here's the funny thing. The wheel wasn't invented for traveling at first. The first wheels were used to make clay pots and vessels. But soon, human beings realized that they could be using the wheel for something better. Around 5,500 years ago, the human beings started building carriages that were tied to horses and supported on wheels. When the horses moved fast, the carriage would also move as fast without the human having to spend much energy. So people could now transport huge and heavy things over long distances. For thousands of years, animals were used as the main way in which people could travel. And then, in 1712, the next major invention happened. Something called the steam engine. The source of the fuel was water. So they would just boil water with coal. And you know what you get when you boil water with coal? You get steam. And they used the steam that was produced to move machines. The first major use of the steam engine was developed in 1804 for trains. Railroads were constructed for these trains to go from one place to the other. Then, for a few years, the steam engine got improved upon. It was made smaller, smaller, more mobile, and it was called the automobile or the automobile. It had a movable set of wheels and it didn't need a railway line. So if people didn't want to travel as far as the other side of the country, they needn't have walked, they needn't have gone by train. They could just use their automobiles. The steam engine wasn't just used on roads, it took to the water too. Boats and ships then got motorized. Traveling by water got so much faster. They would use steam to turn turbines under the water to propel the ship or the boat forward. Instead of using oars to move the boat, this was much faster. Importantly, much easier as well. Human beings decided that land and water wasn't enough, and eventually they took to the skies. In 1900, the Wright brothers invented the first aircraft, a flying glider, that would take off with the help of air currents and land after a few meters. It was also slowly improved upon to carry more goods and passengers across countries and continents. This was much faster than any other mode of transport. And the best part was that you could go really far. It covered the longest distances, thousands of kilometers, in a matter of just a few hours. Steam was now replaced with fossil fuels, like petrol and diesel. Well, what is the advantage, you may ask me? Automobiles started to become smaller, quieter, faster, more comfortable. We gave those automobiles a new name too. Cars. Petrol and diesel was being used everywhere, and people came up with all sorts of travel solutions for all sorts of situations. Bikes and mopeds for one or two person travel over short distances. Cars for little groups of people over short or longer distances. Buses for a large group of people over a longer distance. Trucks for transporting materials and things. Some places even had weird, cute three-wheeled vehicles called tuk-tuks, which were used as taxis. After the age of petrol, the next fuel was electricity. Trains were the first vehicles to run on electricity, then cars, then bikes started picking it up.
If you like this video and if you want to watch more videos like these, hit like and subscribe to the channel. If you enjoy learning this way, download BYJU'S, the all-new and personalized learning app.